To new students coming into this industry, whether you want to be a drafter, a designer, or an engineer, one of the things that I would advise is take time to learn to love the process of learning. It is an industry where you have to continually upgrade your knowledge, your skills, and that information is out there. You have to go look for it. I work with high school students in career tech education. So one of the things that I mentioned to them, particularly in their senior year, is that it's called commencement for a reason, because it is a beginning. It's the beginning of your life. Your next step is your first step into what you're going to do. And maybe you don't have to decide right away what you want to do for the rest of your life, but start exploring the possibilities. Students who discover what they're passionate about and what really makes it exciting for them to hit the floor running when they get out of bed in the morning, that is key to finding a career that you can be satisfied with. If you love what you're doing, if you love your job, if you love the work that you do, you never will feel like you have to work a day in your life. When you work for an employer, even though you are maybe even an entry-level person working for minimum wage, you still need to put out a product that carries the pride of workmanship. And you need to treat it like your name is in that title block, that it's your company. Is this the product you'd want to put out for your client? Learn from the people who have been doing it before you, because they have traveled that road. They have mounted those obstacles. They have created those processes. And maybe they can be tweaked. Maybe they can be improved. But it's not your job to come in and improve them. It's your job to come in and learn them. And then once you've been doing them for a while, maybe you have suggestions for improving them. Part of time management is understanding communication. Email is not an urgent communication. If someone needs something right away, they need to understand that they need to call you. That's an urgent communication. So I always have to take a look at what is my main purpose, what are my upcoming deadlines, and then look at these other tasks or other assignments that support that and do those second and third. Soft skills like communication, working well with others, prioritizing projects. Unfortunately, most of the time people learn by doing, and they become better over time. And there are obviously so many resources now with the internet. You could Google any of those things and get tips and tricks and classes, online classes and in-person classes and a lot of things, but it is really learn by doing. If you want to be a good communicator, practice communicating. Doing it faster does not make it better. It's really important to think through the design process. I don't care if you're arranging fruit or you're designing a bridge. You need to think through, what's my final product and how is this going to be used?